Hi there, I'm Lisa Leek with 100daysofrealfood.com.
And I'm Bonnie Hari with foodbabe.com. For the first time in more than 2 weeks since we launched our petition asking Kraft to remove artificial dyes from their line of macaroni and cheese, Kraft has finally acknowledged our petition and the more than 270,000 consumers who have signed it. Their response posted on their website states that 14 of their 45 or so varieties of mac and cheese do not contain artificial dyes, and the ones that do contain artificial dyes do not violate any FDA or European safety guidelines. However, they failed to mention that when these artificial dyes are used in Europe, they require a warning label stating may have an adverse effect on activity and attention in children.
First of all the macaroni and cheese options here in the U.S. have a similar blue box look, and all those that are geared towards children with phrases like cheddar explosion or cartoon characters all contain the artificial yellow number 5 and yellow number 6. The average consumer is not versed on reading and understanding ingredient labels, so they wouldn't really notice the difference between all these similar looking boxes. And more importantly, many likely don't realize that these dyes are the culprit when it comes to their child's misbehavior and health issues. We've received hundreds of letters from consumers telling us their stories about how these artificial dyes negatively impact their children. And coincidentally enough, just last week, a friend of mine actually sent me a message telling me that her normally smart, kind, very obedient, and well-behaved child, who happens to be in the gifted and talented program at school, had a very strange and disturbing outburst, and she wasn't sure why. Their family normally eats pretty clean, but she happened to let her daughter have a store-bought treat, and shortly thereafter, she had a huge explosive meltdown. She said the last time a meltdown of this magnitude occurred was also right after a similar store-bought snack. And after some discussion, we determined that both of those foods contained artificial dye. So this is what she said in her message to me. This is what happened right after her daughter ate this snack. Her daughter's actual face changed, her eyes became dark underneath, and she became angry and irrational. And at one point, she was even a little embarrassed to tell me this, her daughter yelled, opened the door to their home, and ran outside uncontrollably. Later that night, she cried and said, "Why did I do that, Mommy?"
This is why those telling us, "Just don't buy this mac and cheese anymore," won't work. Because as we mentioned, the average consumer doesn't understand these petroleum-based dyes are a problem ingredient and pose health risks and should be avoided. We have directly reached out to various executives at Kraft since day one of our petition through emails, voicemails, and even tweets. They continue to ignore us personally, and all we want to do is meet with them to come up to some sort of conclusion so we can all move on. We even had our blog readers reach out to Kraft through social media and the Kraft customer service hotline. There were so many voicemail messages left at the headquarters that they were told by many that they couldn't even get through or even leave a message because their mailboxes were full. And by the looks of both the Kraft General and Kraft Mac and Cheese Facebook pages since the start of the petition, there have been overwhelming comments about these dyes, more than 95% of which are asking Kraft to remove artificial dyes from their mac and cheese, just like they've done overseas to the European customers. One reader who attempted to call the Kraft headquarters was told that the organic version of Kraft mac and cheese was one option she could buy without artificial dye. Yet after the customer service rep did a quick search, he could not find that particular product within a 50-mile radius of her home. And she isn't exactly in rural America. She lives in one of the biggest cities in the country, Chicago, which also happens to be right where Kraft is headquartered.
Also in Kraft's response last week, they claim that their customers don't want them to make a change to this product. Who are the people who want their mac and cheese with artificial dyes? These dyes, which only benefit the food manufacturer and not the customer, don't change the flavor or affect the nutritional value of the foods that they're in. They are purely for cosmetic reasons only. So who are these consumers that Kraft says won't settle for anything less? Clearly, Kraft has already figured out a way to formulate their original recipe without artificial dyes for their customers in Europe. We've made and tried both versions, as well as my daughter's and Dr. Oz on his show, and we all came to the same conclusion that they look and taste virtually the same. And we'd like to stress that Kraft has not only removed these artificial dyes from their mac and cheese overseas, they've removed them and replaced them with safer natural dyes from almost all of their product lines, including Lunchables, Trident Gum, Ritz cheese crackers, and Hall's cough drops, just to name a few. And here in the U.S., we're simply asking them to start with their flagship product, macaroni and cheese, which they reportedly sell 350 million boxes of per year. No wonder we haven't heard from them yet. But that's not going to stop us. We're going to definitely still try to get them to take the lead on removing these artificial dyes, which is a small yet significant and positive change for the U.S. food industry.
So if you want to get involved with our campaign to request that these artificial dyes be removed, here are some things you can do to help. One, sign and share our petition at change.org/craftyellow with everyone you know. Two, contact Kraft headquarters and tell them how you feel about their response by doing one of the following. Call their general hotline, write on their Facebook wall, send them a tweet, or email them directly. And three, vote with your dollars by choosing macaroni and cheese and other products from brands that do not use artificial dyes.
Thank you to everyone who's helping to support this campaign. We feel it's an important one. And based on more than 250,000 signatures on our petition at change.org/craftyellow, clearly we are not alone.
We can't wait to celebrate with you when Kraft finally removes these unnecessary yet potentially harmful artificial dyes.